Let's see, Vilya and Lydia and I are. We're on to somewhere. Sightseeing, no doubt. Those towers up the hill from here. I thought we'd go take a look-see. I was trying to get Lydia to hop off and do some combat and then hop back on. See if that undoes the false toggling I've got going on with my ride sharing. If I can get a script to break, it might allow me to flip off one of the MCM settings and then get back on. And then all would be right with the mod. You know, it's the chicken or the egg kind of a toggle. I guess we found combat after getting off the horses. Let's see, is lit. I'm checking if Vilya's broken or not. Looks like Vilya's working. Whoa! I like how in this playthrough, my followers don't fight each other when they get friendly fire on each other. If I lower my weapon, everyone lowers their weapon. Even my Dremora will lower his weapon. Before, they'd all fight each other to the death, and there'd be no way I could stop it. Oops, oops. I thought she was a bandit. She was dressed like a bandit. That's what she gets for racing towards me. It's nothing. Blood on my face. Okay. Where'd they go? We're both blocking each other. Oh, I missed. So these are just vanilla bandits in the game using wildcat combat and the Imperius race settings. So I'm used to how they fight. And I'm used to their active effects that they've all got.
Of course, sir. Very good, sir.
I don't remember if Lydia was wearing an orc outfit or an ebony outfit. I had a dream last night I was using a mod that degrades armor. So NPCs stop using armor if the defense on it goes down. I've used like two or three kinds of mods that do that in the past. They're kind of neat, but then you end up micromanaging everybody, making sure they have perfect armor. It was too much of a chore. I try to balance my game so there's more playing, less managing.
Purple stuff? Oh no!
How I'm gonna get you!
So we have to empty out this fort here. Another fort. This one is, what is it? Fort Ragstad or Hagstad or whatever. I didn't like how they all died that time, so I thought I'd come back in the room. I didn't get a chance to really hit anything.
Now I'm gonna get you.
These guys are pretty good. I mean, they must be leveled up. Because they're staggering me. I can't
you
block
leave him alone.
I mean, I'll block a guy. Oh, the other guy just got reanimated and then dissolved in my face. But the chief guy, the chief bandit here, he was getting staggered pretty good. I'm able to block him, but it doesn't do anything other than just do a timed block. I guess I don't have a perk yet for what happens after you do a timed block. I mean, the only perk I would have maybe is if I swing with my sword, I get extra damage if I timed a block just right beforehand. But I noticed that Vilya, she paralyzes and freezes people when she swings at them with some hammer of hers. And it kind of interrupts or interferes with what I'm trying to do with the bandit chief. So we're both clobbering on the guy at the same time. Plus, I don't want to get hit by her freeze ray. So I'm trying to stay out of her crossfire while I'm fighting people in hallways. It's hard to do. So now we can go back to Solitude, inform Rikka that we've completed the mission here, and then we can go on and do the Jagged Throne, something like that, or the Jagged Crown. I like that. Was General Tully says something to me like, "Oh, and be sure to come back with the new guy when all you find over there is just a bunch of rags and dried, dusty bones." I like Captain Tully's attitude toward things. At the beginning of the Civil War, when you first sign
so
up with the Legion.
I'm so glad we're traveling to Eldeglin Sanctuary together. The sky
He's constantly
is so scary
complaining about order. Nords. You Nords! And all Rikka can do is say, "Sir, I'm telling you, the Ragged Crown is there." You know, that kind of thing. He doesn't believe it. It was the Jagged Crown? I keep saying Ragged Throne when it's the Jagged Crown. The Ragged Throne. There should be a quest called the Ragged Throne. Someone should make that mod right now. I'll play it. I'll put it in a video. Oh, picking up too much stuff, am I? You there. Citizen. Hold this.
I've got your back. How can I serve you, my Thane? Let's get going then.
I thought I'd go look for the steed stone, is that what it's called? Stone of Steed. The one with the horse. I wanted to read what it said on it, because maybe I'll give it a shot, even though I think I'm using the warrior stone right now. This one lets you carry more stuff, and you discover places on your map that are super far away as you travel across the map. Because you're supposed to be higher up on your saddle, so you see farther. So you're able to find, you know, you don't discover places, you just, it just adds them to your map. You still have to go out there and discover the places, but the active effect just allows things to start appearing on your map like crazy. Just because you're nearby those things. You just can't fast travel to any of them until you've discovered them. I don't have fast travel turned on, so I don't worry about such things. When I first started playing Skyrim, I'd hear people say, Oh,
I don't have... I have fast travel disabled in my game. Ugh.
You know, they sounded all, you know, hoity-toity about it. You know, only real role players choose not to use fast travel. And I thought, wow, they're able to play the game without fast travel? Golly gee willikers. That's crazy. That's like hardcore right there, right? Because I was a lazy bastard who just wanted to fast travel everywhere. I don't have time to... You know, that was when I was multi... What do they call it? I was single-track minded when I was playing the game. It's like, oh, I need to do this quest now. I'm going to do this quest now and no other quest. And, what's going on here? What's going on? Whoa. Longest load ever for a... Who are all these people?
Yes?
And they're nice to me.
All right, then.
They're fancy armors. They got the modified mail. Gilded elven armor, which is a lot lighter than the... Oh, these guys. That's why I was loading
up. I thought I heard
we got these guys here. Just vaporize them.
We are
good. Man.
Don't you think so?
She dispatched them pretty quick. I just try to stay out of her way when she's firing that chained lightning of hers. Yeah, so they're wearing the modded mail armor for elves, high elves, the high elf armor. It looks lighter because the default game seems to have this bulky, heavy-looking elven armor, which looks ridiculous. But yeah, I don't... For the longest time, I had fast travel enabled. Because I would just whip back and forth, you know. Back and forth between, you know, Windhelm Riften. Just doing that ping-pong back and forth.
Take a look.
And, so I was trying to hurry up and just do one quest. But in the last couple of playthroughs, I noticed that if I turn off fast travel, I see more stuff. There's more stuff in the game during my travels that I normally would never encounter because I was constantly hopping over all those squares on the board. Now I have to go through each square on the board and see what encounter happens along the way.
Yeah.
So I'm glad I've finally decided to turn off fast travel. And everyone knows that Skyrim is such a small place anyway. It's so teeny. It doesn't take long at all to run across Skyrim. And also, you get distracted along the way. You get sidetracked. You have to go off-Broadway, that kind of thing. So, it's just interesting if you, at least to me, if you have fast travel turned off.
Need a ride? Until next time.
So that's cool, he has a little cooking thing. Nope, I don't have anything to cook though. Oh, this isn't a good... I already know what's gonna happen. Level of detail hasn't kicked in, so the script is jammed. Oh, come on. Oh, we're running off the edge of the map here. The goat! The goat! It's too late. When you see that, it's too late. You can't just run back to where you were. Mother! There's no place like home. There's no place like home. Now, if I try to save now, the game will just crash because the script's jammed. Oh, what the heck. When I hit the quick save button, poof, poof, be gone. Game over, man. Game over. So I thought I'd try again. So yeah, of course it's gonna work now. So I was able to spawn these guys. They were clogging up the system. Oh, that looks way better now.
I have no business with you. Leave me.
The game was waiting on him to show up. He sleeps down by the sawmill outside in a roll bedroll. Him and the other Argonians that are conniving together. Anyway, we're off to see General Tullius so we can do the oath, or I can do the oath at least. And then the Imperial, immersive patrols will come after me.
Sorry, I was lost in thought. I'm planning my wedding, you see. If you want so many details, you should talk to Corpulus.
Yeah, Stormcloaks will begin attacking me on sight when they see me out in the wild. I'm just checking the level of detail at the Blue Palace, seeing if it's been loading up over there, and it looks like it's loaded up. Was that a merchant I just ran past? Oh, there's a bum. Oh, that wall looks interesting. I don't remember seeing a wall decorated like that. I guess I never come running back here to see that wall. Not all the houses even use that texture. Some sort of wood carved paneling of some kind. Maybe it belongs on the interior of a house and it got accidentally put on the backside of that building. Something?
Take a look.
What are these merchants walking around for and they have no bodyguards? What's that about?
Take care now.
You're a fairy tale.
If Ulfric gets his hand on that crown, it won't be a fairy tale. It'll be a problem.
Don't you Nords put any stock in your own traditions? I thought the Moot chose the king.
We're backing Elisif. When the Moot meets, they'll do the sensible thing.
Not everyone's agreed to the moot. You've been here long enough to know that Nords aren't always sensible. We follow our hearts.
So what? Ulfric gets this crown and then suddenly he's High King?
No, it's not as simple as that. But the Jagged Crown would be a potent symbol for his cause to rally around.
What's going on with the 3D space in my game?
And we gave it to Elisif.
In the absence of the moot, it would further legitimize her claim.
Perhaps. I'm helping you with what resources I can spare. But I'm warning you. If this turns out...
I must have a mod conflict. The facing of my character hears things in stereo, in first person, third person.
Send him back when you get there and find nothing but old bones and cobwebs.
Bones and
Stonefist,
cobwebs.
Stonefist's no fool. He's found the crown. But we'll get to it first. Welcome back, soldier. I'm glad you made it in one piece. I'll send men to garrison the fort right away. You
I'm supposed
well.
To hear things in stereo, whether
but
I'm in first person
further,
or in third
time
person.
For you to officially join the Legion.
But I also have other
Speak
mods that
Tullius,
prevent people from talking to me when
in joining the Legion,
my back is facing them.
Binding you to the service of the Emperor,
so maybe that mod is interfering with other stuff. Because no one will talk to me if my back is facing them.
Changed your mind? Decided you wanted to soldier for the Empire after all. Well then.
Maybe I'll need to uninstall that mod.
Upon my honor, I do swear undying loyalty
to the
Emperor.
See if it makes a difference with my 3D space audio.
And unwavering obedience to the officers of his great Empire. May those above judge me. And those below take me, if I fail in my duty. Long live the Emperor, long live the Empire. Welcome to the Imperial Legion, soldier. Just remember, we take care of our own.
I wonder if there's
Once
a mod out there
the Legion,
that will rename all citizens
Speak
to
Baron.
Commoners.
He's normally out by the forge.
Because I prefer...
He'll get you outfitted.
The title of
now,
commoner.
If I'm not mistaken, Legate Ricca has
for all the people
assignment.
That are just walking around the towns. Instead of them saying citizen.
Welcome to the Legion Auxiliary. Listen up.
Oh, she has to do her little thing first. She wants to force greet me, but she also wants to do something else.
Hi there.
And we have to wait for all these quests to start and fail, start and fail. Then she'll talk to me.
Welcome to the Legion, Auxiliary. Listen up. Ulfric's right-hand man, Galmar Stonefist, has located what he believes is the final resting place of the Jagged Crown. We're going to make sure he doesn't get his hands on it. The rest of my men are already assembling outside Corvinjum. I'll meet you there as soon as I finish up here. Don't wait for me. Get to Corvinjum as soon as you're ready. I'll meet you there.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Endoglin Sanctuary together.
Oh, that's right. We haven't done our quest.
Half of the orders appear to me.
We got our loot. We got our flute.
Those orders have been delivered by special courier.
We're gonna get our necklace soon.
I can't trust some of our normal distribution channels.
Understood.
But yeah, we're not gonna do the crazy bottle thing yet. Someday soon. That whole donkey tail quest has to wait. I have more pressing engagements at the moment. Let's go talk to this guy here. Bertrand, is that his name?
Seems there's no end to the needs of
I have no idea what his name is. I can't
I just have one question for
I can't
you.
Read.
Light, medium, or heavy? They don't make finer steel anywhere else.
I don't care what he gives me. I'm just going to sell it or give it away. Or I'm not going to dress up as an Imperial in this game.
Soldier. You lose that or get it banged up. You'll need to pay like everyone else. Return anytime.
I don't have a mod installed that
my forge never rests.
Makes my faction change when I put on different outfits. I like those kinds of mods, but I'm not playing that kind of a game. Is he gonna say something to me? He always waits until I'm out of listening range.
You should see me.
There he goes.
Bored, stranger.
You should see me when you're bored. I was forgetting something here. I probably should. Yeah, I was checking to see if there's any vampires or werewolves killing anything, but no one died apparently. So that's another reason why I need to do the Dawnguard quest. Or at least find Serana. Once I get Serana in the group, then I guess vampires will start showing up in the game. I think I'm still wearing those clothes in my current game. I need to change my outfit. I'm just wearing this rawhide outfit with ebony gloves or some, or steel plate gloves or gauntlets. I need to get the Garanimals armor that matches.